Hey, what's going on, everybody? This video, I wanted to talk to you how we can create a field that is read-only. And by that, I mean you can only assign a value to it at the initialization of the object, but after you set it, it's set with that and you can't change it. Pramp is a free mock interview platform where you can develop your technical interviewing skills. Practice coding with live execution of all major programming languages to solve real interview questions. Interview types include data structures and algorithms, product management, behavioral interviews, system design, front-end, and data science. I've personally used this service to successfully crash course for a software engineering interview. Lots of people are having success getting positions at companies like Amazon, Google, Twitter, and more. Check it out, I'll leave a link for you guys in the description. So the easiest way to do this is to create a constructor that will assign the value. So when you call that constructor, you have the capability of giving that first initial value, but you can make the field private, so then you don't have the ability to change it after that. So to do that, we actually get these fields from the user class. So look at that and change these to private. Now, because when something is private, the only way we can access them is through methods, what we can do is we can create the user constructor. So we'll say public user, and we'll take those as parameters, first name and last name, and we'll just assign those to the fields. So first name is FN and last name is LN. Okay, so this is an abstract class, so we're not going to be invoking this constructor directly in our calling code over here. So what we need to do is we actually need to call this constructor from our student class. So here's how we're going to do that. Go over in our student class, and inside of the constructor here, what we can do is we can actually say super and pass in FN and LN. Get rid of that here, and the parent constructor will do the assigning for us. All right, so let's give it a try. In our code, what we're going to do is we're going to create a new student, pass in a name like so. And so this is how we're going to assign the first name and last name. But if you say S dot, you're gonna notice that first name and last name is not a thing. So it doesn't show up, it's not accessible. But we can still access those values, we just need a way to do that. So for example, inside of the user method, we are currently doing user version. We could alternatively just output the first name and last name. So just as an example, we'll just do the first name and a space and then the last name. This is in the same class, which is why we can access these. Now from our calling code, all we gotta do is say s.sayHello, run this, and look at that. That's how we can get the value. So we can create getters for these fields. You could say get first name, and you could create get last name. Define those inside of the user class, but don't create the set ones. Just leave it so where the constructor is the only way you can assign that. Thank you guys for watching, and be sure to check out the next video.